G'day. Today I'm going to show you how to clean your camera's sensor and also how to check if your sensor even needs cleaning. The things you're going to need to clean your camera sensor are some cleaning swabs, along with some cleaning fluid, an air blower, and of course your camera. I'm cleaning my system today with a VSGO kit. There's a link down below in the description if you want to grab one of those or check in with your local camera store to see what they have. Last thing you want to be doing is using brushes or wet wipes or anything like that on your sensor. You really want to be using dedicated sensor swabs. You also need to make sure that you're using the right one for your sensor. Here I have swabs for full frame, as well as APS-C sensors. Now my Canon 6D here is a full frame sensor, so I'll be using the full frame kit. So you can see here the sensor swabs are different sizes. This is the full frame sensor, this is one for an APS-C sensor. The last thing you want to be doing if you mistakenly got the APS-C swab for a full frame camera is to be taking multiple passes at it. This isn't your car's windshield. We only want to take one swipe. So definitely use the swab that's appropriate for your sensor. So first thing you need to do is expose the camera's sensor. In DSLR cameras, we need the mirror to go out of the way as well as a curtain to go up. In mirrorless cameras, same thing. There's going to be a curtain covering the sensor. So we need to go into menu, into our sensor cleaning and go to clean manually. What this will do is raise the mirror out of the way or the curtain. And as you can see here, we've now got an exposed sensor. Now that the sensor's exposed, first thing we're going to do is just hit it with a dust blower. Don't use cans of compressed air. There's particulates that are in that. If you've ever turned it upside down, you'll see all kinds of crap shooting out of it. Camera facing down, just give it a few good hits with your rocket blower, okay? Just like that. And now that we've given that a bit of a clean, we're going to prepare one of these swabs now to get ready. Now you can do a dry clean with these swabs. Really important, only use one swab per clean. So if you do a dry run with a swab, throw it away and then use another one if you're going to then subsequently do a wet clean. I'll be doing a wet clean today because this Canon has been left open to the elements deliberately so I can show you how to clean these sensors. So let's just get underway with this part. But you can see in there, that is my exposed sensor. Now, even though it might look clean, I can guarantee you I deliberately left this sensor open to the elements for a couple of hours, so I've got a whole heap of dust spots on there. So we are going to get our swab, and this one is for a full frame camera, as you can see here. And just showing you how little of the sensor cleaner, we only want a couple of drops, all right? So it's just a very one, two. See, that's gone through to the other side. And so what we're going to do now is delicately reach into the camera, into the far side, making sure the swab is on the sensor. We're going to give it a swipe left to right, lift it out. I'm going to flip, and then I'm going to come back in here and run left to right again. Now, you can use a moderate amount of pressure here. You don't want to be necessarily gentle, just don't go too commando on the thing. So once we've now done that, so we're no longer exposing it to the elements, just gonna turn the camera off. And as I do, you'll see the mirror come down. There we go. And so now that sensor is more protected, but all the same, I am going to put the lens back on here. So cleaning your sensor is literally as simple as that. You're just going to use the swab, swiping it left to right, flip it over and swipe left to right again. I prefer going in the same direction rather than left to right, flip it and then go right to left. I feel that if you did have a bit of debris or oil, you may be reintroducing it across the end. At the end of the day, it probably doesn't matter which way you do it, just as long as you use a clean swab every time. Now that you've used this one, you want to throw it away. Don't use it again. If you would like one of these VSGO kits, you can use my affiliate link in the description down below or have a chat to your camera store to see what they can supply for you. But you do want to specifically buy a kit that is for sensor cleaning, not a lens cleaning kit. Uses different solutions and doesn't have the same swabs as you've just seen. So how do you know if your camera sensor even needs a clean in the first place? Sometimes it might be a bit obvious in your images that you'll see up in the sky in particular where you'll have cloud, these little dark spots. Now these can be fixed in the likes of Lightroom using the clone stamping tool, which is designed specifically for getting rid of sensor spots as well as other things. So you can simply just clone them out. But if it's getting to the point where your camera is getting really dirty, you'll know that it's time to clean the sensor. But what if you're not quite sure? So the easiest way is to put your camera into aperture priority mode. And what you're going to be using is a large aperture like f16, f18. The way you can test how bad they are is by finding either a blank surface to point your camera at, or go outside and point it at a clear blue sky or a cloudy solid cloud sky. You just want a clear background basically so you can see the dots showing up. Now I'm just going to take a photo using my studio light here. So to see them, I'm going to be deliberately defocusing the lens, because when you've got dust on your sensor spots, your lens can be completely out of focus and you'll still see them. I've got my camera set to f16 and I'm just pointing it straight up into my studio light here, and I'm just going to take a shot. All right. Now, as you can see, look at all those dots. Look at all that muck in the sensor. So there's a heap of it in there, and this is when it's really bad. Now, your sensor shouldn't get this bad, but I did leave my camera open facing up for a couple of hours for this tutorial. So as you can see, we've got all of these dots. The lens was completely defocused. And so this is the trigger that these spots are definitely on the sensor and nowhere else in the imaging train. When they are on the back of your lens, as opposed to the sensor, you might see dots that are bigger and less defined. And then the further away, if it's on the end of your lens, then they become rather large. If you can even see them at all, what you'll probably find if you've got mark on the end of your lens is you'll have parts of your image that are not as sharp and crisp as the rest of it. How does your camera sensor get dirty? Can be via a number of ways. Maybe you've never taken the lens off your camera, but if you have a zoom lens in particular, which the lens will extend in and out as you're zooming, so essentially it's sort of breathing in a way, it can suck air into the camera, and if there's dust or pollen or other contaminants in the air, this is one of the things that can contribute to a dirty sensor. The other way is by swapping your lenses and doing it in less than ideal conditions, or just taking your merry time about it. Ideally, if you're going to be swapping your lens, you want to be in a clean environment where there is no wind. That doesn't always work out for us landscape photographers in particular, or anybody outside. So if you found that useful, I would love it if you hit that like button and, you know, throw me a bit of a subscribe. If you want to find more information about photography and camera gear and equipment reviews, I'll even start bringing that through soon. Have a great day. G'day. 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 Nope. G'day. Today I'm going to teach you how... G'day. 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 I'm cleaning my system today with a VSGO kit. I'm cleaning my system today with a VSGO kit. Did not record.